Alrighty, well, it's getting hot, and I need AC. No central air conditioning in this house, but have a couple of window units, and I don't know if you can really see it on this video. I'm sure you can. This thing is like a really filthy. So I'm going to clean this up and do one minor repair to this. Yeah, it was run over. The hot and the feed was bent over. And as you can see, the ground pin is not in the best of shape. There is a piece broken out because it was run over by a car. Yay. So I'm going to try to fix this. Not quite sure how I'm going to go about doing it yet, but I do have an idea. As far as I know, the circuit is still good. Find out soon enough. Okay, let's see how we do. All right, one of the things I'm going to be doing here is cleaning this condenser. The fins are rather nasty. Sorry, this is an old tripod. Come on, focus. There it is. Yeah, I don't know if you can, well, yeah, I'm sure you can. See all of this stuff. Yeah, that's the stuff that causes air conditioners to not function well. So what I'm doing is using a wire brush right here. Bought this in a kit from Harbor Freight, 6 of them for $2. Cheap. This is kind of like the stainless steel, but anyway, all I'm doing is getting on up in there. Not a whole lot of pressure, but enough to get those little wires in between all the fins. I can't tell if I got you in here or not. Yeah, there we go. So, as I said, you don't want to apply a whole lot of pressure, but you want to get enough pressure to get down in between those pins. The majority of your dirt collection, naturally, is on this side of the condenser. Due to the fact that move you over here so you can see this. This is where all the air is drawn through. This particular unit, yeah, I got this for like $5 at a yard sale. And it didn't have a filter in it, obviously. You don't need to polish these fins, but you want to try to keep them as clean as possible. Now, we're going to get into a section here that is going to be very careful. Here, check this out. That right there. This is kind of like your thermostat, so to speak. And this is on a like a lead tube wire. So, two ways of doing this. Just pull these out. Keeping note of where they're located. I don't know if you can see this. Come on, focus. but they were just kind of like jammed in there, and they wrap around the cooling tubes, the coolant tube. So all I'm going to do is just, I've already removed it. I'm just going to bend this out of the way very gently and try to keep it out of my way. And there we go. Okay. Back to it. Amazing how dust can turn into concrete once moisture has been applied to it and it's been allowed to dry. Now you want to be real careful with these fins. Now I could take off this bottom tray and totally disassemble the entire unit, but I really don't feel like it, so I'm doing it the poor man's way. You could also spray in like 409 glass cleaner or something along those lines, isopropyl alcohol, anything to break up the glue, so to speak. Okay, I'm gonna pause the camera here while I finish this up. There are other little cleanup spots and so on. As you can see in here, it's just as nasty. So yeah, gonna do that. All right, back in a couple of minutes. Okay, she's all back together again, kind of cleaner anyway. Yeah, somebody was a heavy smoker. See the yellow? Anyway, not in the most ideal condition right now, but it is blowing cold, not freezing, but for a small room, 10 by 10 or so, or less, I think this will work fine. All right, so yeah, there you go. Higher, paler, whatever.